in the midline, there are the genial tubercles. So there are superior and inferior genial tubercles. Let me show that to you here. You can see that there are four tubercles. So two pairs of tubercles, genial tubercles, inferior genial tubercles for a muscle that goes down, which is the geniohyoid muscle. And then we have the superior genial tubercle for a muscle that goes up to the tongue. And this is the genioglossus muscle. And also there is another detail here, which is very clear in this picture. Like on the either side of the midline, you can see this impression or this fossa here, these fossae on either side of the midline. Any idea what this fossa is? This is the inferior border of the mandible, close to the midline. And I'm giving you a clue that it is for the attachment of a muscle. So it is the digastric fossa, exactly, or the anterior belly of digastric. And you can see here, this line is the mylohyoid line. So the mylohyoid muscle will be present here. When you have studied the submental triangle, you have seen the mylohyoid muscles, and on inferior to mylohyoid is the anterior belly of digastric. Mylohyoid separates between neck below and mouth above. So this is the mylohyoid line. And there is another fossa here above the mylohyoid line, above the anterior end of the mylohyoid line, or anterior half, let's say, not exactly the end, but anterior half of the mylohyoid line. What do you think this fossa is for? Above mylohyoid. It's not for a muscle. You can say that it is present in the floor of the mouth. So what is there in the floor of the mouth that can create a fossa? So the submandibular glands will be here. You can see this is the mylohyoid line. Submandibular will be located in the submandibular fossa, and it creates an impression somewhere here below the posterior half of the mylohyoid line. But the impression that I was showing you on the last picture was located here above the anterior half of the mylohyoid line. So it is not the submandibular gland. This is the submandibular gland. Yes. Exactly. So that will be an impression for the sublingual glands. Another question in the last 1 minute is, which nerve is closely related to the bone at this location? Well, the nerve to mylohyoid comes from the inferior alveolar nerve and goes to the goes like that. So this will be the inferior alveolar nerve. What about the other nerve here? Exactly. So the lingual nerve is close to the bone here behind the third molar tooth. And here, this is the groove for the nerve to mylohyoid, because the nerve to mylohyoid is below mylohyoid. If you remember when we studied the neck, we can see it's below mylohyoid, and it supplies mylohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. So that will be the groove for the nerve to mylohyoid. Last question is, this is what we call the lingula. It's a piece of bone here, phalangeal bone. And my question is, which ligament is attached to the lingula? You studied that last lecture when you were dealing with the temporomandibular joint. Something mandibular ligament. It's an accessory ligament of the temporomandibular joint. Perfect. It's the sphenomandibular ligament, and the other ligament is the stylomandibular ligament, which is attached somewhere here. But the sphenomandibular ligament is attached to the lingula. Can you tell me where in the sphenoid bone is this ligament attached exactly? It is from the spine of the sphenoid to the lingula. Thank you very much.